And joining me now is Talha Kose, the chair of the political science department at Ibn Haldun University in Istanbul, and Daud Abdullah, who is the director of the Middle East Monitor, a non-profit press monitoring organization based in London. He is also the former deputy secretary general of the Muslim Council of Britain. Gentlemen, welcome to Straight Talk. It's good to have you here. So 1 year passed since the brutal killing of Jamal Khashoggi. We still don't know where his body is. There are credible evidence linking Saudi Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman to the Khashoggi's murder, and there are currently 10 members of the hit team are standing trial for which the international community knows little. So where are we?
Okay, I'll start. I think we are at the stage where the issue is not going away. This is what we can say for certain. After 1 year, the lack of accountability, credible trial and prosecution of those who were involved means that the issue is still alive. We've seen this in the media coverage across the Western world, and indeed the entire world. If you go down to Latin America, this is an issue that is still being debated in the media. But beyond that, I think the efforts of the United Nations Human Rights Commission also played an important part. They conducted an extensive inquiry into the matter, and the rapporteur, Mrs. Kalimad, came out with a very comprehensive report which pointed, you know, it says that the Crown Prince has some questions to answer. So,
yeah, but for a further investigation, I believe UN Secretary General needs to request an international investigation to this matter. Is it possible?
It is, because the nature of the crime is not a domestic crime committed in Saudi Arabia. Mm-hmm. It's an international crime, extrajudicial killing committed by the Saudis on foreign territory. Mm-hmm. This is an international crime. And so it violates a number of conventions, the conventions on the relationships, consular relations. Mm-hmm. So on that basis, there is a possibility of what we call universal jurisdiction, where even though Crown Prince Mohammed, he has not gone to the West, for example.
Yeah.
Even though he was not involved directly, you may say, if he goes to the West, for example, someone in London can file a case for his arrest and prosecution under the framework of universal jurisdiction. Mm-hmm. The crime was not committed in London or in Paris, but it is British citizens and French citizens have the right to make a case against this individual for committing an international crime.
Okay, let's take a look at Turkey's perspective. Mm-hmm. Turkish officials from the very first day kept the international community and interested in this brutal incident. Mm-hmm. What was the goal? What made the Turkish officials decide to keep up the momentum on Khashoggi's murder?
I think from the day one, this issue was tried to be presented as a conflict or a problem between Saudi Arabia and Turkey. And Turkey tried its best to differentiate, first of all, the Saudi Arabia. So this is not a problem between Saudi Arabia and Turkey. Some group within the Saudi Arabia. So we have friendly relations with Saudi Arabia, mm-hmm. But some group take this decision. So the other thing is that this is not a particularly just against Turkey, because Saudi authorities who take this decision violated diplomatic immunity and diplomatic relations between the countries. So mm-hmm. this is at the same time a violation of international law and international diplomacy. So it is responsibility of international community to take some action against this. And the other thing is that the media publicity is very well used. So
why did Turkish officials leak the information bit by bit?
Because, I mean, increase the interest with the case and give information for the international media and take more responsibility for the media and press freedom. So this case is, diplomatic issue, diplomatic problem, is also violation of press freedom and violation of human rights.
Do you believe the Saudis cooperated with Turkey?
Unfortunately, actually, Turkey gave leaked information to allow Saudi authorities to cooperate with Turkey. That was the whole logic. So if they cooperated to address the issue, find out the case, it could have turned into maybe a little bit more closer investigation. But unfortunately, the authorities who involved in the issue or the crime did not cooperate with Turkish authorities. That's why Turkish authorities leaked the information gradually.
Yeah. So, Daud, Turkey demands the extradition of Khashoggi's murderers to face trial in Turkey, where they actually committed this crime. So, is there any chance that Saudi Arabians would do so?
I doubt it very much, because you see, there's a line of command. You know, someone organized this. Mm. Someone gave the order to execute it. And then we had the group who executed it. We know who executed it. They were caught on camera. But then who gave the order and who planned it? This is going right up to the top of the Saudi political establishment. And the fact of the matter is some of those who came to Turkey were, yeah, we had at least three of them were bodyguards to the Crown Prince. So
Very close circle.
Yeah, they all lead into his, you know, into his domain. Mm-hmm. And this is a problem. If you bring these individuals to Turkey and they you know, they are prosecuted and they stand before a court of law, it is likely that the information that is really needed about who gave the order and who planned it, you know, we will get to that that end.
Talha, after Khashoggi's murder, U.S. President Trump sided with Mohamed bin Salman rather than his own intelligence agency, CIA's assessment. He came up with a different conclusion. So is there a risk for President Trump to being so dependent on each other? I'm talking about Saudi Arabia.
Of course, I mean, the President Trump is not dependent on Mohammed bin Salman, but he has an important place in U.S. policies with regard to the region. So you remember those ties between Egypt, Saudi Arabia, UAE, and also the unseen actor there was, you know, Israel. Mm-hmm. So this new project to reshape the Middle East, and one of the important actors for this project was Mohammed bin Salman. So he was portrayed as a great reformer that would change the entire region. So there is a huge investment of U.S. and the other international actors. So on the one hand, some actors within the U.S., the official actors, wanted to invest on Mohammed bin Salman, but this incident distorted his image. So after all these information, it will be much more difficult for Trump to side with.
But there's also going to be elections in the United States in 2020, so.
Yes, I mean,
what if the president changes?
Yes, I mean, the president may change, but some of the lobbies in the U.S. support Mohammed bin Salman.
So, Daud, how would you describe Turkey-Saudi relations? Do you believe Turkey was a bit hurt because U.S. President Trump sided with Mohammed bin Salman and the international community kind of remained silent to this issue?
Certainly. First of all, there's a question of national pride and honor. You know, that such a crime, such a grave crime committed on Turkish territory, never mind the fact it was in an embassy, but in a consulate, the fact is Turkey's sovereignty was violated because you had this international crime being committed here. So in that sense, the relationship was undermined and suffered a serious setback as a result of the crime. Mm-hmm. Politically, again, it's very low-key. The Saudis, the Turks will not cut the relationship. They have to keep it going. But as we said earlier on, there's a distinction between the Turkish, the Saudi establishment
and the
people who were involved in
the crime. Yeah, President Erdogan also underlined in an article on Washington Post that they will continue to shed light on the murder of Khashoggi, but at the same time, they'll try to preserve the friendly ties with Saudi Arabia, right?
He also didn't go to bin Salman personally. He chose to go to the king. He always had the link with the king rather than MBS because he was a suspect, you know, a direct suspect. So he chose to go to the king in all his interventions.
Okay. I'm afraid we have to leave it here, gentlemen. Thank you very much for joining me on Straight Talk.